Hi, it's Katrina. From bushy Arctic foxes to soft chinchillas, here are 10 of the fluffiest animals in the world. Number 10, the alpaca. This cuddly creature is related to the llama and is native to the Andes. Interestingly enough, there are no wild alpacas. Indigenous people domesticated other similar camelid species, such as the vicuna and the guanaco, and alpacas are highly valued for their soft wool. Domesticated alpacas and their pals, the llamas, could be more than 6,000 years old. While llamas were used as pack animals, the alpaca was raised to be fluffy. There are two distinct types of alpaca: the huacaya, which is covered in fuzzy wool-like balls, and the suri alpaca, which has long hair like a sheep. Some people call them silky dreadlocks. Alpacas are very social and can become great pets and even service animals. However, they are not for everyone because when they get stressed, they can spit and kick and make all kinds of noises, even screaming noises. Alpaca fur is prized by artisans and crafters who use it to make all kinds of warm and soft clothing, even stuffed animals. Fun fact, compared to other livestock, alpacas don't eat very much, only about 1.5% of their body weight every day, according to Live Science. While alpaca's soft fleece makes people feel extra cozy, in Peru, sometimes people will also eat them. Unless you're starving, why eat an alpaca when you can snuggle up to one, right? Number 9. The Arctic fox. One of the fluffiest and cutest creatures is the Arctic fox. It's a cool creature that is right at home in the snow and freezing temperatures. Also, they look lily white, but can actually change their color to brown or gray when the weather gets warmer, so they can camouflage better. As its name indicates, they are found throughout the entire Arctic tundra, from Alaska to Canada to Russia, Scandinavia, and even Iceland. They are built to survive temperatures of minus 58 degrees Fahrenheit, and even has fur on the soles of its feet so that they don't freeze when they're running around the tundra. They make a burrow as their home, or simply dig into the snow to make a tunnel if conditions catch them off guard. Their big fluffy tail is very helpful in keeping them warm. It eats an omnivorous diet, which means it can consume some diverse stuff, from plants to other animals. So while food can be difficult to obtain out there in the snow, at least it has options. Their white coat helps them to follow polar bears to eat their leftover scraps and whatever else they can find. Number 8. Black and white ruffed lemur. This next fluffy animal is probably familiar from the Madagascar movies, but of course there's more to the lemur than just dancing around the rainforest making jokes. In some ways, they're quite mysterious in that not much is known about how they're distributed across their habitats. You can find it in Madagascar's eastern rainforest, as well as on an island with a really cool name, Nosy Mangabe. The black and white ruffed variety is also one large lemur. It can weigh up to 9 pounds and is among the biggest of the species. But one of the best things about this not-so-little lemur is the way it helps its environment by spreading pollen. When they feed, pollen is attached to those ruffs on their faces. Then, when they move on to the next tree, the pollen goes with them. They play a very important role in Madagascar's ecosystem and are considered critically endangered. Number 7. The chinchilla. Though a rodent might not be the first thing you think of when looking for a pet, you might be surprised to find out this fluffy thing is just that. As well as being known for their super soft fur, the chinchilla, part of the Chinchillidae family, is regarded as a sociable creature, so if you're getting one, you should actually get two so that they don't get lonely. That's because in their natural habitat of South America, the chinchilla likes to be part of a herd. They're used to running around the place, but if there's one in the house, you have to be careful not to leave any exposed wires, as they will chew through those things like licorice. And if you're one of those people who likes to party all night, then the chinchilla may join you, as it's a nocturnal animal. They also need very special care and should never take wet baths. Sounds a bit like gremlins, right? But don't worry, they don't transform into hideous monsters. The explanation is more regular, but a little strange. Instead of water, they clean themselves in sand. Their fur is extremely dense, and because of their softness and coloring, they have sadly also been hunted and bred to make expensive fur coats. Number 6. Ducklings. All together now. Aww. The chinchilla was pretty cute, but it's got competition now in the shape of these adorable baby ducks. Not that they lead very relaxing lives. The birth of a duckling can be a really hazardous thing for a few reasons. Having left the nest after 10 days of relative comfort, they have to tackle the water. You know that saying about taking to something like a duck to water? That only applies to grown-up ducks. Ducklings have a tough time getting used to the wet stuff, and many wind up drowning because of their soft feathers. Their downy feathers aren't quite waterproof yet, and it's something that's acquired over time. Adult ducks have an oil gland where their tail is and stronger, thicker feathers, making it easier for them to swim around. So ducklings rely on their mother's oil when taking those first steps into the water. They grow up, of course, but are at their fluffiest and sweetest while still in infancy, so we should make the most of that sight before they grow bigger and fly the nest. Number 5. Angora rabbit. If you've heard of the Angora rabbit, it's probably because of the clothing industry. Angora wool is much sought after, but has a complicated history, and animal rights groups are not happy about the way that they're treated, similar to the chinchillas. But don't worry, I'm here to tell you about these adorable little rabbits themselves, and not how they are used. Angora was the name of what is now known as Ankara in Turkey. Angora species in general are believed to have come from Turkey and were introduced to Europe by the French. In Turkish, they're called Ankara Tafsani. There are different breeds of Angoras: French ones, satin ones, and giant ones, which are obviously the biggest and weigh around 10 pounds. My favorite is the English one because with its distinctive facial fur, it stands above the rest in terms of sheer fluffiness. They are also known as puppy dog rabbits. They need a lot of care because that extreme fluffiness can be a hazard and cause major problems due to rabbits swallowing their own fur and potentially getting their digestive tracts blocked. Ouch! A way around this is to carefully shear them to avoid them inadvertently snacking on themselves. It's not so easy being cute. Number 4. The palace cat. This feline friend, or to be more precise, wild cat, probably wins the title of most famous animal on this list, at least in 21st century terms. Its image has gone viral as memes, as well as making the now obligatory appearance on YouTube. Why is that? Because despite it being a wild cat who could probably claw your face off, the palace cat is super cute. It's a mini wild cat native to Central Asia and is also found in Western China. The name palace comes from Peter Palace, the German naturalist who classified it in the 18th century. It has a distinctly rounded and stout appearance, making it look like the type of creature you'd want to pick up and cuddle, though I don't recommend you do that. Their plush coats also conceal the fact that they're skinnier than they look, with the fluff doing all the work. Generally, they can reach 26 inches and weigh 10 pounds. Unlike most cats, they have unusually long and dense fur. Also, they don't run very well, which is crazy for a kitty, right? They prefer to ambush their prey rather than chase after it. So if you annoyed one and it was coming after you, it should be quite easy to run away from. Number 3. The Pomeranian. These pint-sized dogs are packed with personality and are also very versatile. Meet the Pomeranian, a 7-inch pooch with a double layer of fur. Their fox-like face and brave personality have made them a favorite throughout history. While they come in a small package, the Pomeranian is quick, active, and not afraid to get in anyone's face. It's called that after the Central European Pomerania region and is known for being the pet of choice for royalty and everyday people alike who want to have a cute, fluffy animal around the house. They can also be raised in a variety of locations, provided you train them right. This feisty friend has a rep for being happy and full of energy, just what you need in a family dog. No wonder Pomeranians are so popular. Just look at Boo, who was voted the world's cutest dog. Boo had over 16 million likes on Facebook, and while he sadly passed away in January of this year, 2019, he was loved around the world. Number 2. The red panda. With its russet coloring, white head markings, black limbs, and of course that stripy tail, the red panda is one amazing little creature. It can be found in the forest areas of central China, Burma, and Nepal, and half the population is based in the eastern Himalayas. The red panda can grow to a length of 2 feet and is often compared to the size of a domestic cat. Its fur is fluffy but also really thick to keep warm at high altitudes with lots of moisture. Like the Arctic fox, the tail has a dual purpose. It's used for balance but also doubles as a warm blanket. This beautiful animal is unfortunately on the endangered species list with an estimated population of under 10,000. Climate change is believed to be a major contributing factor. A sad reminder that even though these animals are cute, they are also under threat from all kinds of human activity. Number 1. The snow leopard. We've seen some impressive kitties before, but the snow leopard may take the crown. It's a remarkable big cat that roams across its home in the Central Asian mountains. This loner leopard is fluffy for sure, but it has to be to brave those icy winds. The snow leopard is a carnivore, but don't worry if you run into it. For starters, it tends to chow down on blue sheep, argali, which is another kind of sheep, and ibex. Also, it stays hidden a lot of the time, so if you do spot one outside of a nature documentary, you are very lucky. A bigger threat to the proud snow leopard is, you've guessed it, us. It's estimated that their population in the wild might be around 4,000. Anyway, don't want to end on a downer, so here is another picture of a cute and fluffy baby snow leopard. Enjoy the beauty of these magnificent and, above all, fluffy creatures. Thanks for watching! Are there any fluffy animals that you'd like to add? Let me know in the comments. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!